This is your News 4 update, powered by the Bomarito Automotive Group.
Thanks for choosing News 4, everyone. I'm Maurice Drummond. Here are some stories making headlines. The nation's top infectious disease expert says that January may be even worse than December when it comes to COVID-19. Dr. Anthony Fauci made that warning even as December marks the deadliest month during the pandemic. At the same time, the COVID-19 vaccines are being distributed across the United States. Across the country, more than 2 million people have received the coronavirus vaccine. The CDC says that nearly half of the 11.5 million doses of the vaccine have been shipped. That means that there are 9 million doses of the vaccine that's waiting to be given across the country. Those numbers are far cry from the 20 million people that we were told that would be immunized by the end of the year. News 4 asked the head of the St. Louis Pandemic Task Force about the slow rollout.
We'll say, you know, this is still a huge response. This is, you know, a once in a century pandemic. And so you got to kind of expect that there's going to be some hiccups along the way. Now, hopefully we can catch up with vaccine delivery and to get more people immunized in the community so that we can start seeing our way to the other end of this pandemic.
We now know that dentists will be next in line for vaccinations. The profession is considered to be the group 1B on the list. They run a great risk of contracting COVID because it's one of the few jobs where patients cannot wear masks. The Greater St. Louis Dental Society expects their first doses in early to mid-January. News 4 is tracking the decreasing 7-day positivity rate in the bi-state. In Missouri, it sits at 16.8%, and in Illinois, it's at 7.2%. Full case count can be found on our Camel V News app. Time now for a check. Yes, and how are we looking on this Tuesday afternoon, Matt?
And Mo, nice to see you. Good afternoon, everybody. We're looking okay. I just want to give everybody a heads up. If you're traveling west, say west of Columbia, Missouri, or north, maybe north of Hannibal, Mo, during the late evening or overnight hours tonight, it's going to be a mess. We've got winter storm warnings and winter weather advisories up there. This is a system that's moving in our direction, but by the time it gets here, warm air will have taken control, and it turns out to be a big rainmaker for us. That's the plan for Wednesday. First, let's plan the rest of your Tuesday, though. 3 o'clock this afternoon, not really warm. Actually, temperatures falling a little shy of the norm for this time of year, 37 degrees thanks to that cloud cover. You might see a stray sprinkle or a flurry until about 4 or 5 this afternoon, and then it should be pretty quiet. By 6 p.m., temperatures bottoming out a little bit at an odd time of day at 35 degrees, and then look at this. By 9 or 10 o'clock tonight, they're heading back upward as warm air moves in advance of our next weather maker. 9 p.m. temperature at about 37 degrees. I think we're going to be warmer than that by the time anything starts falling from the sky around here, which should happen starting overnight tonight. Watch that clock in the upper left-hand corner. I'll start it at 10 p.m. and then I'll freeze it at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. Lots of cars on the roadways tomorrow. I hope the wipers are in good working order. The good news is this won't be ice or snow. It's going to be too warm for that. 44 degrees, but I want you to bank on a really good chance of a pretty soaking rain tomorrow, but just rain. Too warm for anything else. By 2 or 3 in the afternoon, the back edge of that rain is approaching or maybe is even in metropolitan St. Louis. And look at this, little pinks and whites back to the southwest, indicating maybe just as the rain comes to an end, you see a couple of snowflakes mix in, or maybe just a little bit of sleet if conditions are just right. But that's unlikely, and even if it did happen, it wouldn't happen for a long enough period of time to cause slipping and sliding on the roadways, just wet roads. And most of that should be over and done with by about 6 p.m. That's when the chillier temperatures really start to filter in. It's going to get pretty cold by early on Thursday morning, but that precipitation by that time settles well to our south. It's no longer a local problem. So Wednesday, 90% chance of rain, especially in the morning and the first part of the afternoon. When it ends, there might be a few snowflakes right on the tail end, and then that should be that, at least for a while. I think Thursday morning, which is New Year's Eve morning, by the way, will be dry, but there's about a 40% chance as you're ringing in the new year later in the day that we might have a little mix or some rain around. Stay tuned for updates on that. And then on New Year's Day, that would be Friday, a high of 50, but a pretty good chance of precipitation. But with 50 degrees for the high, that's going to be all rain. 60% chance of rain there. And then Maurice, the first weekend of 2021 looks dry, just a little cooler.
All right, we'll take dry to start out the new year. All right, Matt, thank you very much. And that is your News 4 update. Remember that we're always online at CamelV.com, and you can also check us out on our CamelV News app. Have a great day.